North Korean missile test, everything we know about the highest ballistic missile they've ever launched. North Korea has launched another ballistic missile in the latest demonstration to raise tension between its neighbors and the United States, and one that officials have called one of the highest ever launched by the rogue regime. The missile launch marks nearly 24 missile launches since February, a period of time in which U.S. President Donald Trump and North Korean leader Kim Jong-un have engaged in an increasingly aggressive war of words over North Korea's nuclear ambitions. Here's what you need to know about the most recent missile launch. The altitude: the missile reached an altitude of roughly 2,485 miles, 4,000 kilometers, above Earth. To put that in perspective, the International Space Station orbits at an elevation of roughly 249 miles, 400 kilometers. The distance the missile traveled between roughly 597 miles, 960 kilometers, and 620 miles, 1,000 kilometers, from its launch site, in Pyongyang, a city in South Pyongan province. The time the missile was launched from that North Korean city at 3:30 local time, 18:30 GMT. It traveled for about 50 minutes before coming back down to Earth, hitting waters in Japan's exclusive economic zone off the coast of Honshu, Japan's largest island. The type: according to South Korean news agency Yonhap, South Korean military officials believe the projectile to have been a Hwasong 14, a type of long-range ballistic missile. The reaction: Mr. Trump was briefed on the missile launch while it was in the air, and later seemed unfazed. "We will take care of it," Mr. Trump told reporters in Washington. "It is a situation that we will handle." U.S. Defense Secretary James Mattis described the missile in terms that made it sound unprecedented in scope, and said that the missile was designed to cross to other continents if needed. A little over 2.5 hours ago, North Korea launched an intercontinental ballistic missile. It went higher, frankly, than any previous shot they've taken, Mr. Mattis said, alongside Mr. Trump. Japanese officials, meanwhile, said that they would never accept North Korea's continuous provocative behavior, and indicated that they thought it was a long-range missile. The European Union said that North Korea was violating international agreements, and that the missile test was a further unacceptable violation of those obligations. South Korea appeared ready for the test, and conducted its own missile test off its east coast just 6 minutes after North Korea's launch. That missile demonstrated the country's ability to attack North Korean missile launch sites if necessary, according to a statement from the South's military. Little advanced notice officials said that there were no photographs taken from aerial surveillance that would have indicated the North was planning on a missile test, further bolstering the theory that North Korea has begun putting fuel onto their missiles while they are still horizontal instead of as they wait on a launch pad in launch position. Potential to hit the U.S. East Coast: early calculations, according to Daryl Kimball, the executive director of the Arms Control Association in Washington, told the New York Times that the missile was the most robust intercontinental ballistic missile ICBM launched by North Korea yet, though weighing that it is tough to know if it had been unofficially weighted to look more menacing than it actually is. Early calculations suggest that it could reach the east coast of the United States, Mr. Kimball told that paper. However, that don't take into account the payload mass, which could limit the range.